What's up guys, welcome back to a brand new episode of FluidTV, and today's video is a little bit of a different video, and this is one of the last in real life videos that I will be posting on this main channel. So if you like this sort of video style, make sure to check my second channel out. It will definitely have way more in real life videos in comparison to this one. So thanks again and enjoy the video.
Sup squad, it's my shed, it's where I make all my stuff. Got my nice big anvil here, 100 kilos of just pure awesomeness. You can see the markings here, it's a Peter Wright anvil. Well, to be specific, it's 224 pounds, which is more like 102 kilos, you know? And since we're down here, we can span over to this beautiful hammer that I had made. Me and my buddy Zayden made this motherfucker. You see my touch mark there. And an impromptu Z for his name. This is a rounding hammer, pretty nice. This is my sort of go-to hammer. It's about 4 pounds. Then we also got this hammer. This is my hammer-making hammer, this big boy. This is a, I think, a 7.5 pound hammer. Use this one-hander. Fun fact, it's actually bigger than this sledgehammer, which you use two hands. But I never use it because it's too light, because I'm a big boy. Anyway, we've also got my forge here. Got some hammers in there that I'm making at the moment. This bitch will get to like 1300 degrees. Fucking nice, top notch. If we span over in this direction, you'll see some of my tools that I use on a semi-regular basis. Got my table saw here. Actually my dad's table saw, but don't worry about that. Use that for cutting up hand materials and, you know, knife handle stock and that sort of stuff. Got over here, wood belt sander. This sander, use this for getting shit nice and flat. Top notch. This beast of a drill press. No, a really shitty drill press vice. No, it's 60 bucks for eBay. Nothing special about that. Thick mixer, nice. Rarely ever use that, but I've got it in the shop anyway, so. Bandsaw as well, dull as fuck blade. A couple of things here that I need to put in. My logbook is just here, so you know, got this nice piece of Huon Pine Burl here. Like, get some really nice knife handle material out of that. Gotta cut it up on the table floor over there. If we move over here, we'll stop admiring the timber. Quench tank, it's where all my knives get hard. No, fucking hard. Yeah, got my hammer rack over here, all my belts, brace of stuff, go from low grit to high grit, it's like a 40 grit here, all the way up to these motherfuckers. This is a 1500 grit, smoother than a baby's arch cheek. Anyway, got my drifts over here, I was sort of organizing stuff before, so we've got like hammer drifts and that sort of shit. My belt grinder, goes nice and fast and nice and slow. It's called a VFD, so it changes speed, put it down to a very low speed, so it's like the speed of a file, you know? Like, I can put my finger here, it's fine. It speeds up, and up. It goes like 4.5. Cameras in progress here. Still gonna touch mark those and clean up the faces, but they're basically finished and ready for grinding. Shitty vice. What else? We've got a Damascus blade that I got for a custom order. Unpunched hammer stock, what all my awesome hammers start out as. Hacksaw, grinders and shit, no, top notch. Come out here, now we're moving out of the shed. So out here, this is where I do the majority of my sort of heavy, you know, heavy forging. I do the finer work inside, but this is what's called a fly press. It's a sort of like a 7-ton hand-powered press. You can see it's on a screw here. When I wind this, this rises up, and we do a little test here. When you close it, likes to squish stuff. You know, pretty simple. Squishes shit. So I've got different dies in here. This is a little 3-inch folding die. Got all this stuff here that I can interchange. This comes off here, undo this, and that comes out there. So I do all my sort of heavy hammer work in here. Out here, sorry. Draw the Damascus work and everything like that. It's a great all-round tool, really. So over here, this is sort of like my scrap pile. It's where I get all my resourced, you know, reused timber from. You remember inside there was a blade vise. This is a busted one that I'm just using. Oh, one last thing. This is my trusty blacksmith leg vise. A big handle on it. A really aggressive screw so that it moves really quickly. I'll make this spring myself. Because it didn't come with it. This is a busted one that I'm just using for the materials because it's made of a thing called wrought iron, which is it's sort of like the 1800s version of mild steel. It's like really coarse, so when you etch it, it shows a really cool pattern. What else have we got here? Got an old forklift fork that I've started to cut apart. It's pretty cool. I used to make a lot of train track anvils. Probably made up like a couple hundred now. So that's what I used to start with. Apologies for the noise. Got some leaf spring here. Very good knife making steel. I make a lot of my knives out of that. Got a thermite fucking pourer thing here. Like when they needed to repair train track, what they do is they get a setup and you can see it's all fucking funky in there. This would be on top and they'd have like a little mold underneath. They'd melt the thermite through and you know, sort of join the pieces back together. Got a bunch of fucking hollow tubing, square, like fucking rectangular tubing in there. That's what my actual fly press came on. Big old springs. These springs are actually from a train car carriage. So this is the sort of thing that you find in a car versus this. So it's a bit different in size. Other than that, other random bits and pieces. I think this is like a pin for a bulldozer or some shit. More wrought iron here. Train track. Another bit of forklift time. Yeah. Having an old sort of scavenged steel is just really nice to have around, you know, for the odd jobs you don't really need high quality material for. And then again, like leaf springs and coil springs and that sort of shit, it's good material anyway, so it's good to have around. Yeah?
Alright, it's gone.
So what we've got over here, these are what's called coil springs. This one particularly is actually from a train car carriage. So it's, you know, fucking thick as old shit. This is the kind of one that you'd get in a car as a dog just crawls off my shoulder. So you can see the size difference. So obviously different purpose. Fucking like this would be holding up like 20 tons of weight. This one would be holding up like max 2. These are great resource timber. I use them a lot for my hot punches and that sort of stuff. Dog, get the fuck out of the way.
All right. Let's do something interesting.
Is that good?
Morgan. Alright, quick.
So these are coil springs. You see they come in all different shapes and sizes. This one's for a car, this one is for a train carriage. And you've got in between sizes. This one actually belongs in here. These are both for the same purpose. But these are really good reused material. You can see they're very springy. So they're good for making punches and knives and stuff out of. Like I've done some nice hunting knives out of exactly this one, but this one. So it's really good material. I like using old salvage steel, mainly because it's cheap, but also it's just nice to, it's a nice story behind the product. You know, it's gone from something and turned into something different. So it's nice for the customer. But yeah, it's just nice to be able to reuse stock and turn it into something new and useful again. I'm gonna do another one. There's literally only one more that I can cut my nose with here.
Oh.
Stop wobbling. It's still going.
I'm done for now, damn.
Oh,
rip. No.
we finished making hammers. We didn't actually finish. I just wanted to stop because I got bored. Now we're at this beautiful beach. Not actually at the beach, but just like on a fucking cliff because we're sketchy. Join me on this log while I show off my beauties.
So first blade we got, this is a, I think like a 5-inch blade, sort of mosaic hunter thingo. It's got some nice tassie blackwood for the handle. Ripples really nicely in the light. A heirloom fit onto a 416 stainless guard. And then the pattern is, I think it's about a 20,000 layer explosion mosaic Damascus that I made myself. Yeah, so pretty nice blade. Good for like fucking hunting shit. So yeah. So for this second lovely blade here, we've got a mosaic 115mm Japanese Nikkiri. This is sort of like a vegetable cleaver of sorts. It's nice and tall so that you can pick shit up and then fucking put it in the pan or whatever. So this is actually the first mosaic I ever made. Turned out pretty nicely. It's got a octagonal faceted coolabar burl handle with a brass spacer in there. So for this one here, it's actually one of my favorite pieces. It's a 170mm Brute Deforge stainless samurai gyudo. Gyudo's a Japanese just for like a general chef knife. So it's three layers with a stainless, a 416 stainless for the outside layers, and then it's got a core of 1075. It's just got fucking rainbow colors going up the blade. It's so nice. When you get in the right light, that is. And the handle, it's octagonal faceted like the Nikkiri. We've got a Fiddleback Jarrow handle with a G10 spacer and a coolabar burl bolster. All the edges have been nicely rounded, so it's nice and comfy. Yeah, it's one of my favorite blades. So this one's got to be one of my favorite blades that I've done so far. This is my Murder of Crows Mosaic Damascus Steel, named after the little birds that just fly off the blade. It's so nice. It's an integral bolster and a Huon Pine sculpted handle. Really nice fit to the hand. It's a 200mm long chef blade, and yeah, that Huon Pine just accents the blade so nicely. It helps the pattern move.
If you made it to the end of the video, thank you so much for watching this far through, and if you like this sort of content, make sure to check out my second channel. It will literally be mostly cinematic content like this and just stuff that I like posting, whereas this main channel will just be more less in real life sort of stuff. So just feel free to go check out my second channel, and thanks again so much for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.